silence through the night. What a thrill. I'm searching and I'll melt into you. What a fear in my heart, but you're so supreme.
I am the Fury. The flames of my rage will incinerate you. I came back from space. As I returned, I had one vision. The world set ablaze. And do you know what I saw there? Fury. A great and terrible fury at being alive. Now, you're going to feel the scorching heat of that horrible blackness. Where'd you go? Son of a bitch!
Die!
My suit! Ignition!
Ignition! Fire! Snake! You all right? Snake! Snake!
Thank you. Disgusting. Disgusting.
Waste.
your stance. Snake! Snake!
Boss,
This is the end of the Copras. You've got to live on. You're the only one left. I'm off. To join the Sodom. Mission Control, do you read me? I'm coming home. I see the Earth.
Disgusting. Sick.
Good. You've finally made it inside Groznygrad.
Finally.
Stay alert. This is the enemy's main base. The security here is on a scale you haven't encountered yet.
No kidding.
Your objective is the weapons lab. It's the giant building in the center of the fortress. Sokolov is in the west wing of that building. To get into the area where Sokolov is imprisoned, you'll need to find Major Rykov, steal his clothes, and disguise yourself as him. Rykov is supposed to be in the east wing of the weapons lab. Start out by sneaking into the east wing of the weapons lab, then neutralize Rykov and take his clothes. The weapons lab is to the northeast of the area you're in now. Head northeast.
must still be in this area. Find him!
What's wrong? Thank you. Sir.
Here it is.
You can count on me. What about the Philosopher's legacy?
I don't know anything about that. What are you? Are you trying to kill me?
What's the matter?
I know nothing, I swear it. No one but the Colonel knows of the legacy.
I see.
No, don't! Who's there? You're the man from the CIA. What are you doing here?
I told you before, didn't I? I'm going to get you out of here.
A man of honor, just like your commander. But I'm afraid you're too late.
Too late? Don't tell me. The Shagohods.
Exactly. The final preparations for Phase 2 are complete.
Sokolov, what exactly is Phase 2?
To put it in technical terms, it's a composite range extension system for medium-range ballistic missiles. The Shagohod was originally designed as a tank that could launch nuclear missiles from any type of terrain. There was just one problem we couldn't figure out how to solve. The ICBMs we have today are simply too big for the Shagohod to carry. But the military would not hear of it. They demanded a weapon that could launch a nuclear missile directly into the American homeland. That is when I came up with the idea for Phase 2.
But there's no way you could load an ICBM onto the Shagohod. So how'd you do it?
By accelerating the Shagohod itself.
Accelerating it?
In Phase 2, a rocket booster unit is attached to the frame of the Shagohod. The unit incorporates the same technology used in the Vostok rocket that sent Major Gagarin into space. Using this booster, the Shagohod can achieve a land speed of over 300 miles per hour.
That monster can go more than 300 miles per hour?
Yes. And from this state of accelerated motion, it launches a nuclear missile.
So, the Shagohod acts like the first stage of a rocket.
Yes, precisely. The range of the missile launched by the Shagohod thus increases from 2,500 miles to 6,000 miles.
6,000 miles? That's enough to strike anywhere in the United States.
Not only that, with the Shagohod, there's no need to construct giant silos like the ones used to house ICBMs. All you need is a runway about 3 miles in length, or its equivalent. And you can launch a thermonuclear strike against any location in the United States from anywhere in the Soviet Union. It cannot be detected by spy planes or satellites. It's a mobile fortress, capable of deploying in secret and launching its payload at any time.
A weapon from hell.
A complete completed prototype now sits in the hangar. At present, it is the only one of its kind. But Vulcan is planning to mass-produce them based on that prototype.
And deploy them all over the Soviet Union.
Yes, and that's not the end of it. He's going to ship them to Eastern Europe, to Asia, to all the countries of the Eastern Bloc. Even worse, he intends to use the Shagohod as bait to foment armed uprisings among dictators, ethnic insurgents, and revolutionary groups throughout the Third World. His funds are nearly limitless. He could start mass production tomorrow if he wanted. The reason that tensions between East and West have settled into a Cold War is because each side fears the other's power. Deterrence. The idea of using threats to keep one's enemy in check is the perfect word to sum up this state of affairs. But the Shagohod goes far beyond the level of threat. It will render the concept of deterrence utterly meaningless. If such a weapon is unleashed on the world, it will not be long before all nations are engulfed in conflict. The Cold War will end, and the entire planet will be consumed by the fires of war. Vulcan and the Shagohod will be at the center of it all. So you see, it's already too late.
No, it's not too late.
What do you mean?
We've still got a chance. All we have to do is destroy the prototype and the whole facility before they can mass produce it.
But...
just tell me what I need to do to destroy this place.
All right. The liquid fuel used in the rocket engine is stored in a tank. If you can blow it up somehow... some C3 ought to be enough to blow the entire hangar to smithereens.
C3? You mean that cutting-edge plastic explosive?
It could be molded into any shape. The bomb of the future.
Where can I get it?
There was some in the armory here, but it's gone now. It was stolen by a female spy who was here a minute ago.
Eva?
No, that's not her name. Her name is Tatiana. She made her way in here by becoming Vulcan's lover.
I thought she was your lover.
Mine? Oh, no. She is Vulcan's lover. This is my lover.
Who are they?
My wife and daughter. They're in America.
Now I remember. Your family is in the custody of the CIA. How long has Tatiana been here?
Only a few weeks.
A few days before the Virtuous mission, then.
She said that Khrushchev sent her.
What did you just give her?
All of the experimental data for the Shagohod. Please, it is essential that you destroy the Shagohod.
I will, but first I've got to get you to safety.
No. I'm not going.
My mission is to rescue you.
Leave me.
Sokolov!
Khrushchev has abandoned me. I cannot return to my country. I would most certainly be sent to the gulags.
What about the US?
Yes, I once thought of that. My family's waiting for me there. But even if I fled to the United States, I would once again find myself creating weapons of mass murder. In the end, it doesn't matter where I go. I am still a weapons scientist. To be honest with you, I'm tired. Every day I help create things that should never be used, things that should never have existed in the first place. Every day, without sleep, without a word of praise from others. And my creations do not even benefit mankind. They are merely the tools of politicians. All I wanted to do was build space rockets. But it was not to be. The space race between America and Russia became the prey of politicians. The space race and the arms race are one and the same. Missiles, rockets, what's the difference? Scientists are always being used. Please, watch over my family.
Major, what are you doing here? I've been waiting for you in my room.
Who are you?
Don't play dumb with me. If you think you can fool me, you're sorely mistaken. I know the Major better than anyone else. I come here looking for Tatiana, and what should I find? But a greasy freebooter.
Fairy disguise. It's gonna rub off on you. And then you'll lose sight of who you really are. Stay out of this!
See why they call you the boss. What was that? Some kind of judo?
No, it's called CQC, a basic form of close quarters combat. He and I developed it together.
Splendid. I'll take it from here.
Are you going to kill him?
Of course. But first, I will make him pay for hurting Ivan. Tell me!
Stop it!
Who have you been talking to?
He doesn't know what you're talking about.
You'd better start talking.
Please, stop this!
Who is Khrushchev's lapdog?
How can you do this to him?
I know you gave the data to someone.
Never do
that. You!
You monster.
I guess he's dead. Now then, I hope you'll prove more entertaining than he was. But first, let's take a look at your body, shall we? You're a tough one, my friend. A lesser man would be dead by now. This ought to be interesting. Well then, let's get started. What is your target? Is it the Shagohod? Or Sokolov? Or maybe it's the Legacy? Answer me! Who is helping you? Who let you in here? Whoa. You're a tough one, but even you must have your limits. And I am a patient man. Where the fun really begins. My body carries an electric charge of 10 million volts. Let's see how you like this. Now answer me. How much does the CIA know? They're after my legacy, aren't they? Your real target is the Philosopher's Legacy, isn't it? Yourself go. That's what I want to see.
It's no use. He's not going to talk. He's been trained not to break. Trained by me.
Admit it! We're after the location of the Legacy! The secret fund established by the three great powers during the two world wars. That's what you're looking for, isn't it? $100 billion, divided up and hidden all over the world! And you're looking for a record of where all that money is hidden, right? No matter. The Philosopher's Legacy is safely in my possession, in the underground vault of Groznikrat. You'll never lay anything on it. What's this? A transmitter. Who's responsible for this?
I am. I planted it on him to keep track of his movements.
Why?
So the Cobras could ambush him.
If they knew where he was gonna be, they wouldn't have gotten themselves slaughtered. It pains me to do this, boss, but under the circumstances, I'm afraid I must ask you to show me some proof that you and he were not in collusion.
You don't trust me. Is that it?
Not that. But he is your apprentice.
What do you want me to do?
Let's see. Cut out his eyes. I don't like those blue eyes of his. There's nothing more important to a soldier than his eyes. You made him a soldier, and now you will unmake him. Yes, it'll make for a touching display. He's all yours. Do it! Ruin him, just as he did the Cobras. What is it, Tanya?
He's suffered enough.
Well, well. Why are you protecting him? That smell. Tatiana, you're the spy.
What are you talking about?
I know that smell.
Stop it!
Taking a fancy to her, eh, Ocelot?
No. I have no interest in this woman. I want to test her. I'll let this be the judge.
Do as you like.
Go.
Satisfied now?
Well, that was refreshing. Come, we're going to my room.
So you survived the Colonel's torture, eh? Watching this has made me realize something. It's really not that bad. It's the ultimate form of expression. You got lucky this time, Tatiana.
Run!
I've prepared an escape route for us. Go out and head west. Pass underneath the connecting passageway and go north. You'll find an open manhole there.
You're...
Quiet! Go through the manhole down into the sewers. The door at the north end of the sewers is unlocked. You can use it to get outside the fortress. I've got your equipment. We'll meet up later.
Eva...
But I can't get too close to your cell. You'll have to figure a way out of there yourself. I'll be in touch.
Huh? What? You don't want this? Tell me he got out of here! What's going on here?
Ready to save, Snake?
This is horrible.
What's wrong? Are you okay? Oh, jeez. Did you throw up?
Did you manage to escape?
Yeah, I'm out.
Be careful. In your present state, you're practically naked. You don't have a single decent weapon, and you'll never survive in a battle. Take some time and pull yourself together. Eva says she's recovered your equipment, so rendezvous with her as soon as possible to get your gear back. Use the escape route Eva set up for you.
Snake, you're already in the sewers?
Eva, yeah, I just got down here. I'm coming to meet you now. The door at the north end is open, right?
Snake?
Let me guess. There's a problem.
Yeah.
What is it this time?
The Colonel found out you escaped.
He did, huh? I figured as much.
Yeah, and now all of Grozny Grad is on red alert.
Just my luck. But once I'm out of the fortress...
You can't get out.
I can't?
When the fortress went on red alert, they sealed off the sewers.
You've got to be kidding me.
I'm serious. And that means the escape route I laid out is...
Is sealed off, too.
Right. And they just sent a unit out looking for you.
Down here?
Uh-huh. They'll be there any minute now. You've got to get out quick.
But isn't the exit sealed off?
You should be able to get out by heading straight north. Book it, Snake. If they find you, you're dead.
Damn good.
I've been waiting for this. Nobody interfere. This is where it ends.
Whose lives you have ended.
Snake, are you all right? That was a close call.
What the hell happened to me?
You were halfway drowned at the bottom of the river. Almost crossed over to the other side.
Other side? So that really was.
Something on your mind, Snake?
Major, was there a man in the Cobra unit called the Sorrow?
Yes, I've heard of him. He was an uncanny soldier who fought alongside the boss.
What kind of man was he?
The Sorrow was a man with, well, special powers. He had ESP, which was the subject of extensive research in the Soviet Union at the time. He was especially gifted as a medium.
A medium?
Someone who can communicate with the spirit world and evoke the spirits of the dead. In other words, he could talk to ghosts. They say he could find out what was going on in a battle by talking to dead soldiers.
What about him and the boss? What was the story between them?
I don't know the details. Why don't we ask Sigyn?
Yo! I finished checking up on this Sorrow guy a while ago. Thought you guys already knew, though.
Knew what?
That he's dead. He's been dead for 2 years now.
Died 2 years ago?
At Selenoyarsk. You know, those cliffs you were at. And the boss is the one who did him in.
The boss?
Yep. 2 years ago, the boss was sent by the CIA on a secret mission to Selenoyarsk. That's when she met the Sorrow, who'd gone back to the Soviet Union after the Cobras broke up at the end of the war. Except this time they were enemies.
And then what?
The boss killed the Sorrow herself and accomplished her mission. At least, that's what the records say.
So, he was never there in the first place. He just couldn't let go of the boss.
You okay, Snake?
Yeah, I'm fine. It looks like it's not time for me to die yet.
I sure hope not. Otherwise, the whole mission is shot. We're counting on you, pal.
Roger that. Eva?
Snake, you didn't call. I was worried. Are you all right?
Yeah, I took a pretty freaky detour.
What are you talking about?
Nothing. Forget it. Let's just say I'm back.
Good. But how did you escape from the sewers?
I jumped into the river.
From all the way up there? You're out of control.
Yeah, I got carried away by the current and almost drowned.
Great. That's perfect.
What do you mean that's perfect?
I mean, if you ended up in the river, then I know a good spot nearby. Let's meet up there.
Where is it?
Keep going upstream until you get to a waterfall.
A waterfall, huh?
Right. Behind that waterfall, there's a cave. We'll meet in there.
The cave behind the waterfall upstream. Got it.
See you there.
pretty tasty.
Nice to meet you, Snake. I'm Tatiana. Here's your equipment.
Eva, you could use a towel.
So could you.
Want some?
No, thanks.
Don't like snakes?
Not for dinner.
Didn't you have to eat them at the KGB?
In my training, we always got the good stuff. French, Italian, that kind of thing.
A regular Matahari.
The least you could do is call me Cynthia.
Tell me something. How does it feel to spy on your own country?
I can't say it feels good, but it's my job.
Can't even eat a snake during a mission, huh?
I wouldn't mind eating you. When this mission's over, you'll have to treat me to a nice dinner.
What do you want to eat?
Let's see. How about sushi?
Sushi?
It's Japanese. I hear it's all the rage right now. Supposedly, it's made from raw fish.
Raw fish? Just the place for my survival techniques.
What a thrill. Darkness and silence through the night. Snake? Thank you, Snake. What a thrill. I'll be your eyes from now on. I'm searching and I'm melting to you. What a fear in my heart. But you're so supreme.
Don't worry about it.
Are you all right?
It's not like I can't see. I've got one good eye and can still fire a gun.
Really? Good.
Eva, didn't you steal some explosives out of the fortress?
C3, a highly potent explosive from the west. It can be molded into any shape, like clay. With just this much, you could blow up the Shagohat and the lab along with it.
Is that right?
Yeah, but there's a trick to using it.
Tell me about it.
Well, what do you think? The Shagohod's booster unit uses liquid fuel. The fuel tanks are in the main wing of the weapons lab, in the hangar housing the Shagohod itself.
So I should blow up the tanks?
That's the basic idea. It should be enough to blow up the entire hangar. There are 4 fuel tanks. In order to destroy the hangar, you'll have to set explosives on each of those tanks.
All 4 of them?
It should be no sweat for you. Besides, the scientists had the day off today.
So the hangar's completely deserted?
Not quite. They've still got guards posted there.
So what do I do after I set the C3?
The bombs run off a timer. Once the timer has been set, the countdown will begin. When the timer reaches 0, the bombs will all go off at once.
How long do I have?
20 minutes. Once the phase 2 trials are finished, I wouldn't be surprised if they kill all the scientists to prevent them from talking. So you've got to act fast.
I'll take care of it. Eva, did you get the data on the Shagohod from Sokolov?
Yeah. That's the mission I was given.
By Khrushchev?
Mm-hmm. America doesn't have any use for it, does it?
Huh.
But I haven't forgotten my other mission either. Helping you out. Follow this cave and go up the ladder at the end. You'll come out inside Groznygrad, just southwest of the weapons lab. Do you remember when you went to rescue Sokolov? Remember there was a locked door when you entered the main wing from the second floor of the east wing?
Yeah.
That's the entrance to the Shagohod's hangar. Use this key to open that door.
The door right when I entered the main wing? Got it. What about you?
I'll get things ready for our escape. There's a rail bridge to the north. I'm gonna set a bomb there, so I'm taking half of the C3 with me.
Right. I'll set off the weapons lab then. Try not to be in the neighborhood when it happens.
Gotcha.
And watch out for Ocelot. He suspects you're not who you say you are.
Don't worry. The Colonel still trusts me. And I have my ways. There's not a man alive who can resist my charms. Besides you, of course.
I'm just warning you, Eva. That's all.
I know. Okay, let's go.
You seem like you were born on one of those.
If I didn't ride every day, I couldn't go on living. Huh? When I'm riding, the wind hits me so hard that it hurts. That pain keeps my mind off the pain of having to be someone else. It's not easy always fooling myself like this. It's only when I'm on the bike that I'm free to be the real me. I only get off my bike when I fall in love or fall dead.
What's your name?
Tatiana.
No. Your real name.
What's wrong with Tanya?
Okay, Tanya. Don't let anyone see you.
Oh, this? It's a button camera.
What did you do that for?
Insurance. To make sure you don't double-cross me.
Hey!
What?
You're gonna get wet again.
What's wrong?
Huh?
What's wrong? What's wrong?
Huh?
What's wrong?
Come in, HQ.
This is HQ.
Control here. The enemy is attacking from an unknown position. Begin the alert status.
Acknowledged. Sending reinforcements. Use extra caution.
Come from?
We'll be right back.
Nice.
I see him!
Huh?
Footsteps.
Huh?
Thank you.
Snake, I see you've managed to sneak into the hangar.
Yeah, the Shagahod's in here.
The completed Phase 2 Shagahod represents a grave threat to the West. We can't allow it to be mass-produced. You've got to destroy it.
Eva's got the data on the Shagahod. Do you think that's safe?
Well, I wouldn't exactly say it's safe, but Khrushchev is a shrewd leader. I can't imagine he'd use it for anything other than deterrence. Volgin, however, is a different story. He's planning to use the Shagahod to turn the Cold War into a blazing hot one. We can't let him have it.
Agreed.
That leaves just one more mission for you to carry out.
The boss.
Exactly. For now, just focus on destroying the Shagahod.
Yes, sir.
I'll let Sigint fill you in on how to destroy it.
Yo, like Eva was saying, if you're looking to blow the whole place sky high, the best way is to take out those liquid fuel tanks with the C-3. You know there's four tanks in there, right? You have to put C-3 on all four of them. To plan a C-3 charge, all you gotta do is equip the C-3 and press the weapon button while standing in front of a tank.
Just like TNT.
But make sure you don't plant it in the wrong place. You barely got enough C-3 as it is, right?
Good point. I'll make sure not to plant it anywhere else.
Good, man. And be careful. Liquid fuel has a nasty habit of going off at the slightest shock. So don't go using any heavy firepower near the tanks unless you're aiming to get yourself barbecued.
I'll keep that in mind.
The C-3 charges all have to go off.
C-3
explosive detected on the liquid fuel tank. Calling all EMD staff to the hangar immediately.
Snake?
Eva.
I finished planting the bomb on the rail bridge. If we get rid of the bridge, the enemy won't be able to follow us. That should at least buy us some time. I've also set up the escape route. How are things going on your end?
I just finished planting the second charge. Give me a little more time.
Okay. I'll be waiting for you at the bridge.
You this time. Major, I finished planting the C3. I'm on my way out now.
Hurry, Snake. Is Eva taking care of the escape route?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
She can handle it.
All right, then. Well, hurry up and get out of there.
Snake!
Why'd you come back?
This woman was found snooping around my underground vault. When she was captured, look what we found on her. The Philosopher's Legacy. This microfilm contains all the information regarding the Legacy. You might say that this film itself is the Philosopher's Legacy.
It was the smell that gave her away. No, not the perfume. It was gasoline. Motorcycle gasoline. She reeked of it.
To think that lovely Tatiana was a spy. We found this radio along with her too. Such a fine woman she was. It almost pains me to have to kill her. Yes, she was an obedient one. She was my precious little pet. Isn't that right? What was that? Do you have something to say to me?
Go to hell!
You dirty whore! I've had enough kisses from you! I should have known. Sokolov wasn't man enough to have a lover like that. Just like the KGB to send something so beautiful, yet so deadly.
What is the philosopher's legacy?
Very well. I'll explain it before I kill you. During the last Great War, the most powerful men in America, China, and the Soviet Union had a secret pact. The pact was a blueprint for defeating the Axis powers and creating a new world order. To secure victory in the war, the three countries pooled their resources to conduct the most covert types of operations and research. The atomic bomb, rocket technology, the Cobra unit. And they amassed an enormous sum of money to fund these projects, enough to fight the war five times over. That wealth is the philosopher's legacy. After the war was won, the three countries were to divide the philosopher's legacy amongst themselves. This explains why the United States and the Soviet Union were able to steal away the best scientific minds in Germany as soon as the war ended. But our great motherland has far surpassed its pathetic rivals. We possess enormous wealth, the most advanced technology, and overwhelming power, assets fitting of our great country. My father was one of the men in charge of managing the philosopher's legacy. In the confusion that ensued after the war ended, he devised a series of ingenious plots to ensure that the Soviet Union would have total control over the legacy. The money was divided up and laundered through banks all over the world. Switzerland, Australia, and Hong Kong. This microfilm contains a record of all those transactions. After my father's death, I learned of this secret and obtained the microfilm. With this money and the support of Brezhnev and his allies, I built this fortress of Groznygrad and Granin's research facility. But that worthless fool Granin failed to produce results. I was forced to turn to Khrushchev's dog Sokolov and his invention, the Shagohod. My position in Gru made it too troublesome to attack Sokolov's facility directly. But the spy network established by the secret pact still existed. I used it to contact the boss and suggested that she defect. The boss was conniving enough to see things my way. The world was once one, but the conflict between the philosophers has torn it in two. We will use the legacy to heal that rift and make the world whole again. To do this, we need strength, an unstoppable trump card with enough power to bring order to the world. That trump card was to be the Shagohod and the Cobra unit. I have lost the Cobras, but I still have the Shagohod and the Legacy. There is nothing America can do to stop us. Boss, take this someplace safe. Take good care of it.
He wouldn't have come waltzing back in here unless he had a reason. The C-3's been stolen. He must be planning some sort of sabotage. I'll go see if there are any surprises waiting for us. I'll dispose of her as well. Leave everything to me. Fight like a warrior, Volgan.
But of course.
Let me face him. I've been waiting for this moment. Time to get even. No more judo, and no more field strips.
Enough of this. He's mine. You will stand right there and watch. Got it?
Please, Colonel, let me—
Silence! Sorry for the delay. Let's get started, shall we? This is a once-in-a-lifetime battle. Let's make it a good one.
Thank you.
boss! fighter you are! Fire, Ocelot! You dodge this one! Put away your gun!